I'm Dr Janette Young and I work at the University of South Australia as a lecturer in health promotion. Here at the University of South Australia, in partnership with a group of specialist veterinarians and consumer representatives and specialist aged care advisors, we've developed a tool that assesses the risks for the key species that people keep as pets in communal aged care settings so that they are able to take their pets with them. Generally, there's not policies that say no pets, it's just that it doesn't happen. And so the reason why we were developing this tool was to actually facilitate the possibility of it happening more readily. Often what happens is that people have this sense of just the risks are being too huge to overcome for someone to bring their cat or their budgie or their dog in with them. I mean, most of these settings now people have their own rooms. And so what we were looking at is particularly people think about the concern of dogs biting staff, that kind of thing. And so that can become a barrier to every dog coming with their owners into care. And so what we've done is actually we worked with specialist veterinarians across the main species of animals that people have as pets to actually identify all of the risks that we could identify and then map those risks in terms of likelihood and level of impact if they happen. So some of the risks are actually really low likelihoods of happening. So many of the diseases that people may worry about, if animals are properly vaccinated and good hygiene practices are in place, which they are in aged care anyway, it's not new stuff, then people are safe, but also animals are safe. We have an ethos of creating everyday homes for people in aged care facilities. So when someone is no longer able to live in their home, that they should be able to move into, as when they need to, they move into a facility that they can still feel at home and do the things that are important to them. And pets are every day, as we've said, you know, over 60% of households have a pet. It's very ordinary, very everyday. And so it's about facilitating the ordinariness, which is part of their requirements in their aged care standards. There's also what we know, which is that people going into particularly high level care, it's very distressing and depressing for people. And so the opportunity to take their pets with them, which for many of us are actually those relationships alleviate anxiety and concerns for many of us. You know, when you've had a bad day, you go home and the dog loves you. It's actually taking that understanding and saying that's part of our lives as we age as well. And so what we know from other research is that for older people, pets help people to negotiate transitions much more smoothly. And so you're actually taking that knowledge and inserting it into the system where they're having some of the biggest transitions of their lives. It's people don't go particularly into high level care settings willingly. They don't sign up to do that. It's people's biggest fear often. So if we can reduce the stress at that really stressful time, then we will see better outcomes in people's lives into the future while they live there.